Hi, Ashley here, and today I'm going to show you how to transfer rhizomorphic mycelium. First, I recommend being in front of a laminar flow hood or in a sterile environment. Then, sanitize everything before you start. There are two major classes of mycelium, rhizomorphic and tomentose. Rhizomorphic mycelium is more strandy and stringy looking, and tomentum mycelium is more cottony and fluffy. Rhizomorphic mycelium is also known to grow faster and more apt to produce primordia. So knowing these facts, we definitely want to transfer out our rhizomorphic mycelium so we can have better genetics. Here I chose the strand that had grown together from two rhizomorphic sectors, and I tried to choose the thickest, strongest strand that had intertwined and connected together. Then you just simply cut the agar from the petri dish and then transfer it to a new petri dish. And that's it. That's how you transfer rhizomorphic mycelium, and then wrap your petri dish with parafilm. Thank you guys so much for watching. We can start to see the mycelium get a little bit fluffy here, so we know there is a little tomentose mycelium too. You could do another transfer to try to get better rhizomorphic growth, but for now, I'm just going to transfer the whole puck to a spawn bag and continue to grow it out in the spawn bag. Next, I'm going to show you how to transfer agar to a spawn bag. First, I recommend being in front of a laminar flow hood or in a sterile environment. Then, I recommend sanitizing everything. I am using a pre-sterilized spawn bag that I got from Spawn Magic. These bags are great quality and super inexpensive. When you first get these bags, they are tightly sealed and hard to mix. An easy way to mix them is carefully cut open the top and let a little fresh air in. Then, fold over the top and carefully mix the grain. And now they're ready to inoculate. Now it's time to prepare the petri dish. First, remove the parafilm and then open the lid. Next, cut 8 wedges in the dish. And I like to break up the agar like this because I think that it colonizes a lot faster when we transfer it to the spawn bag. Now, carefully transfer the agar to the spawn bag. And with a vacuum sealer, seal the top of the bag, but do not vacuum out the air. Just seal the bag. Finally, give the bag one last mix, trying to mix all of the agar wedges inside of the grain, covering all of them. Looks good. And then don't forget to label your bag. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.